Welcome to Metamora Township High School's production of Fiddler on the Roof. Before the actors take the stage, we'd like to remind you that there will be a 15-minute intermission following Act 1. Food and drink, however, are not allowed back in the auditorium. We also ask that you silence your cell phones at this time. Now, with all that in mind, it's time to sit back and enjoy this classic Broadway production of Fiddler on the Roof.
A fiddler on the roof! Sounds crazy, no? But in our little village of Anatevka, you might say, every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. And you may ask, why do we stay up here if it's so dangerous? We stay because Anatevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word, tradition! Many years, here in Anatevka we have our traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered and always wear a little prayer shawl. This shows our constant devotion to God. And you may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know. But it's a tradition. And because of our traditions, every one of us knows who he is and what God expects him to do. In the little circle of our village, we've always had our special types. For instance, Yenta, the matchmaker.
Mortka, I have the perfect match for your son. A wonderful girl.
Who is she?
Rojo, the shoemaker's daughter.
Rojo? But she can hardly see. She's almost blind.
Tell the truth, Morka. Is your son so much to look at? With the way she sees and the way he looks, it's a perfect match.
And where's Nahum, the beggar?
Alms to the poor. Alms to the poor.
Here, Reb Nahum, is one kopeck.
One kopeck? Last week you gave me 2 kopecks.
I had a hard week.
So if you've had a bad week, why should I suffer?
And most important, our beloved rabbi.
Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing for the Tsar?
A blessing for the Tsar? Of course. May God bless and keep the Tsar far away from us.
Die, 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 die.
And there are others in our village. They make a much bigger circle. His Honor the Constable, the Constable's men who enforce the laws of the Tsar, and many, many others. We don't bother them, and so far they don't bother us. And among ourselves, we get along perfectly well. Of course, there was that time where he sold him a horse, and he delivered a mule. But that's all settled now. Now we all live in simple peace and harmony.
It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
I know it was a horse.
I know it was a mule.
Horse, mule, horse, mule.
Tradition. Tradition! Without our traditions, our lives would be as shaky as a fiddler on the roof!
Should we put these?
Put them on my head. On the table, foolish girl. Where's Hava?
She's in the barn, milking.
Mama, when will Papa be home?
It's almost Sabbath, and your Papa worries a lot when he'll be home. All day long, riding on top of his wagon like a prince.
Mama, you know Papa works hard.
His horse works harder. And you don't have to defend your Papa to me. I know him longer than you. He could drive a person crazy. Ah, Hava, did you finish milking?
Yes, Mama.
You were reading again. Why does a girl have to read? Will it get her a better husband? Here.
Mama, Yenta's coming. She's down the road.
I wonder if she's finally found a match for you, Zeitel.
From your mouth to God's ears.
Why does she have to come now? It's almost Sabbath.
Go finish outside. I want to talk to Yenta alone.
Mama, can I go out and play?
You have feet? Go.
Can I go too?
Go too.
But Mama, the men she finds. The last one was so old, and he was bald. He had no hair.
A poor girl without a dowry cannot be so particular. You want hair? Marry a monkey.
After all, Mama. I'm not yet 20 years old yet.
Shah! Do you have to boast about your age? Do you want to tempt the evil eye?
Go.
Golda.
Darling! I just had to see you because I have such news for you. And not just every day in the week news. What's in a lifetime news? Oh, and where are your daughters? Outside, no? Good. Such diamonds, such jewels. You'll see, Golda. I'll find every one of them a husband. But you shouldn't be so picky. Even the worst husband, God forbid, is better than no husband, God forbid. And who should know better than me? Ever since my husband died, I've been a poor widow. All alone, no one to talk to, nothing to say to anyone. It's no life. All I do at night is think of him. And even thinking of him gives me no pleasure. Because you know, as well as I, that he wasn't much of a person. Never made a living. Everything he touched turned to mud. But better than nothing.
Good evening. Is Zeitel in the house?
She's busy. You can come back later.
But there is something I would like to tell her.
Later.
Oh, Matel, I thought I heard you.
Go finish outside. I said later.
All right.
What does that poor little table Matel want, Zeitel?
They've been friends since they were babies together. They talk, they play.
They play? What do they play?
Who knows? They're just children.
From such children come other children.
Yenta!
Ah, children, children. They are your blessing in your old age. But my errand, he couldn't give me children. Believe me, he was good as gold. Never raised his voice to me. But he was not much of a man, so what good is it if he never raised his voice? But what's the use of complaining? Other women enjoy complaining, but not Yenta. And not every woman in the world is a Yenta. Well, I must prepare my poor Sabbath table, so goodbye, Golda. And it was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other.
Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Off, I'm losing my head. One day we'll fall off altogether, and a horse will kick it in the mud, and bye-bye, Yenta. Of course, the news. It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man. And I don't have to tell you that he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. You understand? Of course you do. Well, to make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eye on Zeitel.
My Zeitel?
No, the Tsar Zeitel. Of course you're Zeitel.
Such a match for my Zeitel. But Tevye wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Listen to me, Golda. Send Tevye to him. Don't tell him what it's about. Let Laser discuss it for himself. You'll win him over. He's a good man. A wealthy man. True? True. So, you tell me how it went, and you don't have to thank me, Golda, because aside from my fee, which, anyway, Laser will pay, it is my satisfaction to make people happy. What better satisfaction is there? So, goodbye, Golda. And you're welcome!
What did she want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Finish with the floor.
I wonder if Yenta found a husband for you.
I'm not anxious for Yenta to find me a husband.
Not unless it's Mala the tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Zeitel, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me.
And after her, one for me.
So if Yenta...
Yenta.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You'll bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see. For Papa, make him a scholar. For Mama, make him rich as a king. For me, well, I wouldn't holler if he were as handsome as anything. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone, so find me a match of my own. interested in a match, Hava. I thought you only had your eyes in your book. And you have your eyes in the rabbi's son.
Well, why not? We only have one rabbi, and he only has one son. So why shouldn't I want the best?
Because you're a girl from a poor family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take. Right? Of course, right. Hoddle, have I been a match for you? He's handsome, he's young, all right, he's 62, but he's a nice man, a good catch. True? True. I promise you'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what. Oh, Hava, I found him! Will you be lucky, bride? He's handsome, he's tall. Tis from side to side, but he's a nice man, a good catch, right? Right. You heard he has a temper. He'll beat you every night, but only when he's sober, so you're all right. Did you think you'd get a prince? Well, I do the best I can. With no dowry, no money, no family background, be glad you God's a man. Matchmaker, matchmaker, you know that I'm still very young. Please take your time. Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could get stuck for good. Dear Yenta, see that he's gentle. Remember, you were also a bride. It's not that I'm sentimental, it's just that I'm terrified. Matchmaker, matchmaker, plan me no plans. I'm in no rush, maybe I've learned. Playing with matches, a girl can get burned. So bring me no ring, groom me no groom, find me no find, catch me no catch, unless he's a matchless match.
I am a horse. Dear God, did you have to make my poor old horse lose his shoe just before the Sabbath? That wasn't nice. It's enough you pick on me, Tevye. Bless him with 5 daughters, a life of poverty. What have you got against my horse? You know, sometimes I think when things are too quiet up there, you think to yourself, let's see, what kind of mischief can I play on my friend Tevye?
Ah, so you're finally here, my breadwinner.
I'll talk to you later.
Where is your horse?
He was invited to the blacksmith's for the Sabbath.
Hurry up, the sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us the cure. We've got the sickness already. I'm not really complaining. After all, with your help, I'm starving to death. You made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune?
if I were a rich man. Diddle, 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 diggy, diggy, diddle, diddle, dum. All day long I'd biddy, biddy, bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Diddle, 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 diggy, diggy, diddle, diddle, dum. If I were a biddy, biddy, rich, diddle, 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 man, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up and one even longer coming down. And one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd see my wife, my golden, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oy, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important men in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise on them, like a Solomon the Wise. If you please, Reptivia, pardon me, Reptivia, posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. Yadadidadadidadadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadidadadadidadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadad
won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. And I'd discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. That would be the sweetest thing of all. Oh, if I were a rich man, diddle 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 digga digga diddle diddle dum. All day long I'd biddy biddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Diddle 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 digga digga diddle diddle dum. Lord, who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan if I were a wealthy man?
Look at it. Hey, here he is. Here. You forgot my order for the Sabbath.
Remorka, I had a little accident with my horse.
Tevye, you didn't bring the rabbi's order.
I know, Red Mendel.
Tevye, you forgot my order for the Sabbath.
This is bigger news than the plague in Odessa.
Speaking of news, terrible news from the outside world.
Terrible.
What is it?
In a little village called Rajanka, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their homes.
For what reason?
It didn't say. Maybe the Tsar wanted their land, maybe a plague.
May the Tsar have its own personal plague.
Amen.
Why don't you ever bring us some good news?
Yeah.
I only read it. It was an edict from the authorities.
May the authorities itch in places that they cannot reach.
Amen.
Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? You all stand around, curse and chatter, and don't do anything. You'll all chatter your way into the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Kiev. A student at a university there.
The university. Is that where you learn to criticize your elders?
That's where I learned that there's more to life than just talk.
Oh,
you should know what's going on in the outside world.
Why should I break my own head for the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
Oh, yeah. Mike, as the good book says, if you spit in the air, it lands in your face.
That's nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He is right.
She's right, and he's right. How can they both be right?
You know, you are also right.
Wait, he's right. He's still wet behind the ears.
Yeah.
Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Good Sabbath.
Tevye, the rabbi's order. My cheese.
Of course. So, you're from Kiev, Red.
Perchik.
So you're a newcomer here. As Abraham once said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me. As King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
For a man with a slow tongue, he talked a lot.
And the cheese.
Here, have a piece.
I have no money, and I'm no beggar.
Here, it is a blessing for me to give.
Very well. For your sake.
Thank you. You know, it is no crime to be poor.
In this world, it's the rich who are the criminals. One day their wealth would be ours.
That would be nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
Like you.
Like me.
Nonsense.
And until your golden day comes, Red Perchik, how will you live?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have any?
I have 5 daughters.
5?
Daughters.
Girls should learn, too. Girls are people.
Oh, radical.
I'd be willing to give them lessons. Open their minds to great thoughts.
What great thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many good lessons for our times.
I am a very poor man. Food for lessons? Good.
Come.
Stay with us for the Sabbath. Of course, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, when a poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
Where does the good book say that?
Well, it doesn't exactly say that, but someplace it has something about a chicken. Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
Children.
Hello, Papa.
Children, this is Perchik. Perchik, this is my oldest daughter.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
You have a very pleasant daughter.
I have 5 pleasant daughters. This is mine. This is mine. This is mine. This is mine. This. This is not mine. Perchik, this is Mazel Cam's oil, and here...
Ah, so you did me a favor and came in.
This is also mine. Golda, this is Perchik. He is a teacher. He is staying with us for the Sabbath.
I'm a very good teacher. A great teacher.
I heard once the rabbi who must praise himself has a congregation of 1.
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
The wit she gets from me. As the good book says...
The good book can wait. Get washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Matul, you'll also be eating with us. Of course, another blessing. Zaitul, 2 more.
Matul can help me.
All right, get the tablecloth. You can wash outside as well. Tevye, I have to speak to you.
Why should today be different?
heavy. I have to say...
Shh. I'm praying.
Laser Wolf wants to see you.
The butcher? About what?
I don't know. Only that he says it's important.
What could be important? I had nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, see him and talk to him.
And talk about what? If he is thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget it.
Tevye, don't be an ox. A man sends an important message. The least you can do is see him and talk to him.
And talk about what? He wants to buy my new milk cow.
Talk to him.
All right. After the Sabbath, I'll talk to him.
Mottel, Yentu was here.
I saw her.
If they agree on someone, there will be a match, and it will be too late for us.
Don't worry, Zeitel. I have found someone who will sell me his used sewing machine. So in just a few weeks, I'll have saved up enough to buy it. And then your father will be impressed with me.
But Mottel, a few weeks may be too late.
But what else can we do?
You could ask my father for my hand tonight. Now.
Why should he consider me now? I'm only a poor tailor.
And I'm only the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
Zeitel, if your father says no, that's it. It's final. He'll yell at me.
Mottel.
I'm just a poor tailor.
Mottel, even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Will you talk to him for me?
All right. I'll talk to him.
It's late. Where is everybody?
Reb Tevye?
Come, children. We're lighting the candles.
Reb Tevye.
Yes, Mottel, what is it? Well, Mottel, what is it?
Good Sabbath, Reb Tevye.
Good Sabbath. Good Sabbath. Come, children, come.
May the Lord fulfill. Ah, Reb Wardka.
Yes, Laser Wolf.
I would like that bottle of brandy and those two glasses, please.
Right away. If I might ask, what's the occasion? Are you getting ready for a party?
Oh, there may be a party. Maybe even a wedding.
Ooh, a wedding. How wonderful. And I'll be happy to make the wedding merry, lead the dancing and so forth. All for a little fee, naturally.
Oh, yes. No wedding is a wedding without you and your fee. Yes.
Good evening, innkeeper.
Good evening.
We would like a drink. Sit down, my friends.
Yes. Vodka? Schnapps?
Vodka.
Right away.
Good evening.
Good evening, Tevye. If I might ask, why are you here so early?
He wants to buy my new milk cow. Good evening, Reb
Laser. Oh, Tevye, sit down. Have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
So, how goes it with you, Tevye?
How should it go?
You're right.
And you?
The same.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So, Tevye, how's your brother-in-law in America?
I believe he's doing very well.
Oh, he wrote you?
Not lately.
Well, then how do you know?
If he was doing badly, he would write. May I?
Tevye, I suppose you know why I wanted to see you.
Yes, I do, Reb Laser. But I'm afraid there's no use in talking about it.
What? Why not?
Why, yes. Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you have a few more without her.
I see. Today you want one. Tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
The same as you do with one.
Look, Tevye, this is very important to me.
Why is it so important to you?
Well, frankly, because I am lonesome.
Lonesome? What are you talking about?
You don't know?
We're talking about my new milk cow. The one you want to buy from me?
A milk cow! So I won't be lonesome. Tevye. I'm talking about your daughter. Your daughter, Zeitel.
Milk My cow. Daughter, Zeitel?
Well, of course your daughter, Zeitel. She comes in my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made a good impression on me, and I like her. And as for me, Tevye, as you know, I'm pretty well off. I have my own shop, a fine house, a servant. Look, Tevye, why do we have to try and impress one another? Let's just shake hands and call it a match. And you won't have to worry about a dowry for her. And you might even find something in your purse, too.
Shame on you, shame! What do you mean by purse? My title is not the sort that I would sell for money.
Just as you say, we won't talk about money. The main thing is, let's get it done. And I will be good to her, Tevye. I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? I never liked him. Why should I? Sure, you can have a fine conversation with him if you talk about kidneys and livers. Well, on the other hand, not everybody has to be a scholar. If you are rich enough, no one will call you stupid. And with a butcher, my daughter will surely never know hunger. Of course, he has a problem. He's much older than her. That's her problem. But she's much younger. That's his problem. I always thought of him as a butcher. But perhaps I misjudged him. He's a good man. He will try to make her happy. What do I think?
It's a match.
You agree?
I agree.
Oh, wonderful, Tevye, wonderful. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you.
No, my friend, to you.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To our prosperity. To good health and happiness. And most important,
to life, to life, like I.
Lakayem, lakayem, to life.
Here's to the father I've tried to be.
Here's to my bride-to-be. Drink, lakayem, to life, lakayem.
Lakayem,
lakayem, to life.
Life has a way of confusing us.
Blessing and bruising us. Drink Lachaim to life.
God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie panting on the floor.
How much more can we be joyful when we've really something to be joyful for? To life, Lachaim.
To Zytel, my daughter.
My wife! It gives us something to think about.
Something to think about.
Drink Lachaim to life. Red vodka, drinks all around.
Ah, what's the occasion?
I'm taking myself a bride.
Oh, who?
Tanya's eldest daughter, Zytel.
Ah, congratulations.
My wife! Fortune never comes, here's to whatever comes. Drink Lachaim to life. Such men, it stands to reason, we deserve it too. To us and our good fortune, be happy, be healthy, long life! And if our good fortune never comes, here's to whatever comes. Drink Lachaim!
To life!
No, Tevye. After the wedding, you and I will be related. You will be my papa!
Celebration.
I'm taking myself a bride, Tevye's eldest Zytel, Lachaim!
May I offer my congratulations, Tevye?
Thank you, Your Honor.
Oh, Tevye, I have a bit of news I think I should tell you.
Yes, Your Honor.
And I'm telling you this news because I like you. You're a decent, honest person, even though you're a Jewish dog.
Thank you, Your Honor. How often does a man get a compliment like that? And your news?
We receive orders at some time soon. This district is to receive a little unofficial demonstration.
A pogrom here?
Well, no, not exactly. Just a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Not too serious. Just some mischief. So that if an inspector comes, he'll see that we've done our duty. Personally, I don't know why there has to be this trouble between people. But I thought I should tell you. And you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor. You're a good man. If I may say so, it's a shame you aren't a Jew.
Tell you, that's what I like about you. You're always joking. Congratulations again on your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Dear God, why did you have to send me news like this today of all days? It is true that we are your chosen people, but every once in a while, can't you choose someone else? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband for my Zeitel, L'chaim.
Now, children, I will tell you the story from the Bible of Jacob and Laban, and then we will discuss it together, all right? Good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the younger Rachel, and he asked Laban for her hand. Laban agreed if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer. Now, after Jacob worked 7 years, do you know what happened? Laban fooled him and gave him the ugly daughter, Leah. So, to marry Rachel, Jacob was forced to work another 7 years. So you see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand?
Yes, Perchik.
Good. Now we'll discuss.
Papa isn't up yet.
No, Mama.
Then enough lessons. We have to do Papa's work today. How long can he sleep? He staggered home last night and fell into bed like a dead man. I could hardly get a word out of him. Girls, come clean the kitchen. Call me when Papa gets up.
That was a very interesting lesson, Perchik.
Do you think so?
Although, I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My little sisters have big tongues.
And what is it that you know about him, except that he is the rabbi's son? Would you be interested in him if he was the tinsmith's son or the shoemaker's son?
Well, at least I know this. He doesn't have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Certainly. Any new idea would be strange to you. Remember, it was the Lord that said, "Let there be light."
Yes, but he was not talking to you personally.
You have spirit, even a little intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it's a rusty tool. Good day, Hoddle.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. Oh, but of course that is too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions! Nothing must ever change. Everything is perfect, exactly the way it is.
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing all over but here. Here, men and women must keep apart. Men study, women in the kitchen. Boys and girls must not touch, should not even look at each other.
Well, I am looking at you.
You are very brave. Did you know that in the city, boys and girls can show affection without the permission of a matchmaker? They hold hands, even dance together. New dances, like this. I learned it in Kiev. You like it?
It's very nice.
There. We have just changed an old custom.
Yes, well, you're welcome. I mean, thank you. I mean, good day.
Good day, Hadi.
Vilki! Sprinze! What's your name?
Hadzel, Papa.
Where is Zaito?
She's in the barn.
Call her out. Ah, Reperchik. How did the lesson go today?
I think we made a good beginning.
Ah, so you're finally up. What happened last night besides your drinking like a peasant? Did you see Laser Wolf? What did he say? What did you say? Do you have any news?
Patience, woman. As the good book says, good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. And there's another saying that goes...
You can die from such a man.
Ah, Zaito, come here, Zaito. You are to be congratulated. You're going to be married.
Married?
What do you mean, Papa?
Laser Wolf has asked for your hand.
I knew it!
The butcher?
Oh, my heart told me this is our lucky day. Oh, dear God, I thank thee, I thank thee.
What do you say, Zaito?
What can she say? Oh, my firstborn upright! May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like Fruma Sarah, that first wife of his. She was a bitter woman. Oh, may she rest in peace. Not like my Saito. And now I must go thank Yenta. Oh, my Saito upright!
Mazel tov, Saito.
You call that a mazel tov? And you, Red Perchik. Aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Idol. For getting a rich man.
Again with the rich? What's wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. Money's the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it! And may I never recover! Idol knows I mean only her welfare. Right, Zaito?
Yes, Papa.
There, you see?
I see. I see very well.
Well, Zaito, why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with this blessing?
Oh, Papa, Papa!
Look easy, tell me.
Papa, I don't want to marry him. I can't marry him, I can't.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself out a servant. I'll dig ditches. Only don't make me marry him, Papa, please.
What's wrong with Laser? He likes you.
Papa, I will be unhappy with him. All my life will be unhappy. Please, I'll dig ditches. I'll haul rocks.
But we made an agreement. And with us, an agreement is an agreement.
Is that more important than I am, Papa? Papa, don't force me. I will be unhappy all my days.
All right. I won't force you.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
It seems it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts of life.
Reptavia, may I speak to you?
Later, mortal, later.
But I would like to speak to you.
Not now, mortal. I have problems.
That's what I want to speak to you about. I think I can help.
Certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, mortal. Goodbye.
At least listen to him, Papa.
Right, you have a tongue, talk.
I hear you are arranging a match for Zaito.
Ah, he also has ears.
I have a match for Zaito.
What kind of match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to measure.
A perfect fit made to measure? Stop talking like a tailor and tell me who is it.
Please don't shout at me.
All right, who is it?
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 It's me. Myself.
Him? Himself? Either you're completely out of your mind or you're crazy.
He must be crazy.
Arranging a match for yourself. What are you, everything? The matchmaker, the guests, the bridegroom, all rolled into one? I suppose you'll even perform the ceremony. You must be crazy.
Please don't shout at me, Reptevia. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a little unusual.
Unusual? It's crazy.
Times are changing, Reptevia. The thing is, your daughter Zaitel and I gave each other our pledge more than a year ago that we would marry.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa. We gave each other our pledge.
Don't I still have something to say about my daughter? Or doesn't anybody have to ask a father anymore?
I wanted to ask you for some time, Reptevia, but first I wanted to save up for my own sewing machine.
Oh, stop talking nonsense. You're just a poor tailor.
That's true, Reptevia. But even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise you, your daughter will not starve.
Ah, he's beginning to talk like a man. But what kind of match would that be with a poor tailor? Well, on the other hand, he's an honest, hard worker. But on the other hand, he has absolutely nothing. Well, on the other hand, things can never get worse for him. Can they get better? They gave each other a pledge, unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him, she wants him. And look at my daughter's eyes, so hopeful.
Well, children, when shall we make the wedding?
Oh, thank you, Papa.
You won't be sorry.
I won't be sorry. I'm sorry already!
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. Mother and children. Wait.
Golda! What am I going to tell Golda?
Mazel, you were wonderful.
It was a miracle. It was a miracle. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God could frown, but like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When David slew Goliath, yes! That was a miracle. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought could never be. God has given you to me.
Golda,
Golden.
Laser! Mortal! Psycho!
Tevye! 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 What is the matter with you? Wake up!
Where is she?
Where is who?
Frumacera, Laser Wolf's first wife. She was standing here a minute ago.
Tevye, what's the matter with you? Frumacera's been dead for years. Oh, you must have been dreaming. Tell me what you dreamt and I'll tell you what it meant.
All right. Only don't be frightened.
Tell me.
All right. This was the dream. In the beginning, I dreamt we were at the celebration of some kind. Everybody we knew was there. And then, in the middle of the dream, in walks your grandmother Zeitel. May she rest in peace.
Grandmother Zeitel? How did she look?
For a woman who's been dead 30 years, she looked very good. Naturally, I went up to greet her, and she said to me,
"A blessing on your head!
Mazel tov, mazel tov!
To see a daughter wed!
Mazel tov, mazel tov!
And such a son-in-law, like no one ever saw, the tailor Motel Kamsoil." Motel? A worthy boy is he!
Mazel tov, mazel tov!
Of pious family!
Mazel tov, mazel tov!
They named him after my dear Uncle Mordechai, the tailor Motel Kamsoil.
She must have heard wrong. She meant a butcher.
You must have heard wrong, Grandma. There's no tailor. You mean a butcher, Grandma, by the name of Laser Wolf.
No! I mean a tailor, Tevye, my great-grandchild, my little Zeitel, who you named for me. Mottel's bride was meant to be. For such a match I prayed. In heaven it was made. A fine upstanding boy, a comfort and a joy, the tailor Motel Kamsoil.
But we announced it already. We made a bargain with the butcher.
But we announced it, Grandma, to our neighbors. We made a bargain, Grandma, with the butcher Laser Wolf.
No. So you announced it, Tevye, that's your headache. And as for Laser Wolf, I say to you, Tevye, that's your headache, too.
Friend and neighbor from Asera. Have you no consideration for a woman's feelings? Handing over my belongings to a total stranger. How can you allow it? How can you let your daughter take my place, live in my house, carry my keys, and wear my clothes? Pearls, how? Pearls! 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 Such a man and man as Tevye wouldn't let it happen. Tell me that it isn't true, and then I wouldn't worry. Say you didn't give your blessing to your daughter's marriage. Let me tell you what would follow such a fatal wedding. If Zeitel marries Laser Wolf, I pity them both. She'll live with him 3 weeks, and when 3 weeks are up, I'll come to her by night. Take her by the throat, and this I'll give your Zeitel, this I'll give your Zeitel, this I'll give your Zeitel. Here's my wedding present to you if she marries Laser.
and horrible dream! And to think it was brought on by that butcher! If my grandmother's idol, may she rest in peace, came all the way from the other world to tell us about the tailor, all we can say is that it is for the best and it could not possibly be any better. Amen.
Amen.
A blessing on my head, mazel tov, mazel tov. Like Grandma Zeitel said, mazel tov, mazel tov. We'll have a son-in-law like no one ever saw, the tailor mazel kamzoil.
We haven't got the man,
mazel tov, mazel tov.
We had when we began,
mazel tov, mazel tov.
But since your grandma came, she'll marry, what's his name?
The tailor mazel kamzoil. The tailor mazel kamzoil. The tailor mazel kamzoil. The tailor mazel kamzoil.
Did you hear? Tevye Zeitel is going to marry...
I know. Laser Wolf the Butcher.
No. Mato the Tailor.
Mato the Tailor? That's absolutely terrible.
Imagine. Zeitel is marrying Mato. I can't believe it.
What's wrong with my son, Mato?
Excuse me, Shinel of Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov. Oh, congratulations.
Mazel tov, Chava. Mazel tov.
Please, may I pass?
Why? We're congratulating you.
Congratulations. Mazel tov.
All right, stop it.
What is wrong with you?
Just stop it.
Now listen here, Fiyatka.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. I'm sorry about them. They mean no harm.
Don't they? Is there something you want?
Yes, I'd like to talk to you.
I'd rather not.
I've often noticed you in the booksellers. Not many girls in this village like to read. Would you like to borrow this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why? Because I'm not Jewish? You feel about us the way they feel about you? I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Well... let me tell you about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow, charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
Well, I often do things I shouldn't. Go ahead, take the book. It's by Heinrich Heine. Happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
You're quite right. Good. After you return it, they'll ask you how you like it, and we'll talk about it for a while. And then we'll talk about life and how we feel about things, and it can all turn out quite pleasant. Good day, Hava.
Good day.
Fiedka.
Good day, Fiedka.
Thank you.
Natural together.
Just the light to newlywed should be.
Is there a canopy in store for me?
Thank you.
My friends, we are gathered here today to share in the wondrous joys of the new newlyweds, Motel and Zeitel. May they live together in peace to a ripe old age. Amen.
Amen.
Ah, and here comes our beloved rabbi. May he be with us for many, many years.
Amen.
Now, I would like to announce that the bride parents are gifting the new newlyweds with the following. A new feather bed, a pair of pillows.
Goose pillows.
Yes, goose pillows. This new pair of candlesticks, and this new set of china. Yes, yes. Let us all be grateful and content, like our good friend Laser Wolf. For he has everything in the world except for a bride. But there's no ill feelings here. In fact, he has a gift for the new newlyweds that he wants to come and announce himself. Come, Laser Wolf.
Yes, yes. Just as he says, there are no ill feelings. What's done is done. I am giving the newlyweds 5 new chickens, one for each of the first 5 Sabbaths of their newlywedded lives.
Reb Laser, you are a decent man. In the name of my daughter and her new husband, I accept your gift. There is a famous saying that...
Reb Tevye, I'm not marrying your daughter. I don't have to listen to your sayings.
If you would listen only a second, I was...
Why should I listen to you? A man who breaks an agreement.
Oh, that can't be best.
All right, all right.
Don't shame Reb Tevye at his daughter's wedding.
I have a right to talk.
What right? This is not your wedding.
It should have been.
Okay, oh.
Reb Laser, not at a wedding.
He shamed me in front of the whole village!
Quiet! The rabbi! The rabbi has something to say.
I say, we all sit down.
We all heard the wise words of the rabbi.
Now I would like to sing a little song that might...
Keep your diseased chickens!
Leave my chickens out of this! We had a bargain!
The terms weren't settled!
We drank on it!
No! Okay,
my own grandmother visited us from
what the grave! Sign, but grandmother! My grandfather came to me from the grave and told me that her grandmother is a big liar!
Quiet! What is all this screaming about? They drank on it. An agreement. A sign. It's all nonsense. Zeitel wanted to marry Martel and not Laser.
A young girl decides for herself?
Yeah.
Why not? They love each other.
Love? Terrible.
He's a radical.
What happens to the matchmaker?
Oh. Yeah.
You don't need a matchmaker.
I say...
We know. Let's sit down.
Now come, let us dance. It is a wedding.
Some wedding. What's he doing?
Who will dance with me?
It's a sin.
Yes.
It's no sin to dance at a wedding.
But with a girl?
That's what happens when you bring a wild man into your house. Yeah. It's not a wild man. His ideas are just a little different.
It's a sin.
Yes. It's no sin. Ask the rabbi. Ask him.
Well, rabbi.
Dancing. Well... It's not exactly forbidden, but...
It's not forbidden!
And it's no sin! Now who will dance with me?
No, don't. Oh my god.
Hotel! It's only a dance, Mama!
She's dancing with a man!
What are you doing?
What is happening?
Oh, gosh. This is absolutely preposterous. This is ridiculous, okay? Unbelievable. A blasphemous. What is this? I don't like this. This is a sin. Unbelievable. Come on.
I see we've come at a bad time. Tevye, I'm sorry. But
The orders for tonight.
Oh, Project, what orders?
Oh.
Project, what is he talking about?
All right, then. Have your fun.
Fun? Project, what's happening? Mama. No! Oh, please! Stop! Project, Mama, stop!
Of course.
Come.
Well, what are you all standing around for? Clean up. That was quite a dowry you gave my daughter Zeitel at her wedding. Was that necessary? Anyway, Mottel and Zeitel have been married for almost 2 months now. They work very hard. They're as poor as synagogue mice, but they are both so happy they don't realize how miserable they are. Mottel keeps talking about the new sewing machine. I know you're very busy, God. Wars and revolutions, plagues, floods, all those little things that bring people to you. Couldn't you take a second away from your catastrophes and get it for him? I mean, how much trouble would it be? Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse's left leg. Am I bothering you too much? I'm sorry. As the good book says, why should I tell you what the good book says?
Please don't be upset, Otto.
Why should I be upset? If you must leave, you must.
I do have to. They expect me in Kiev tomorrow morning.
So you told me. Then goodbye.
Great changes are about to take place in this country. Tremendous changes. But they can't happen by themselves.
So naturally, you feel that you personally...
Not only me. Many people. Jews, Gentiles... Many people hate what's going on in this country. Don't you understand?
But it could be dangerous. You could be arrested. Or even worse.
Otto, your father, the others, they think that what happened at Zeidel's wedding was a little cloudburst. And now it's over and everything will be peaceful again. It won't. Horrible things are happening all over the land. Pogroms. Violence, whole villages being emptied of their people. It's reaching everywhere, and it will reach here. I have to do something. You understand?
Yes, I suppose I do.
I have work to do. The greatest work a man can do.
So, goodbye, Perchik.
Before I go, there's a certain question that I... wish to discuss with you.
Yes?
A political question.
What is it?
The question of marriage.
And this is a political question?
Yes. In the relationship between a man and a woman, known as marriage, there are positive social values based on mutual beliefs, a common attitude and philosophy towards society.
And affection.
And affection. This relationship has positive social values. It reflects a unity and a solidarity.
And affection.
Yes. And I'm personally in favor for it. Do you understand?
Yes, I think you were asking me to marry you.
In a theoretical sense, yes, I am.
Oh, I was hoping you were.
Then I take it you approve, and we can consider ourselves engaged, even though I'm going away. I'm very happy, Huddle. Very happy.
And so am I, Perchik. But when will we be married?
I'll send for you as soon as I can. It'll be a hard life.
Yes, but it will be less hard if we live it together.
Yes.
Good evening.
Good evening, Reptevia. I have some bad news. I must leave this place.
When?
Right away.
I'm very sorry, Perchik. We will all miss you.
But I have some good news. You can congratulate me.
Congratulations. What for?
We are engaged.
Engaged?
Yes, Papa, we're engaged.
No, you're not. I know you like him, and he likes you, but you're going away, and you're staying here. So have a nice trip, Perchik. I hope you'll be very happy, and my answer is no.
Well, please, Papa, you don't understand.
I understand. I gave my permission to Mortal and Zytel, so you feel you also have a right. I'm sorry, Perchik, I like you, but you're leaving. So go in good health, and my answer is still no.
Papa, please, you don't understand.
You're not listening. I say no. I'm sorry, Huddle, but we'll find someone else for you here in Anatevka.
Reptevia, we're not asking for your permission. Only for your blessing. We are going to get married.
You're not asking for my permission?
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my own ears. My blessing? For what? For going over my head? At least with Zytel and Mottel, they asked me. They begged me. But now, if I like it or not, you'll marry him. Tradition! They're not even asking permission from the Papa. What's happening to the tradition? One little time I pulled out the thread, and where has it led? Where has it led? Where has it led? To this? A man tells me he's getting married. Or he doesn't ask me, he tells me? But first he abandons her.
He's not abandoning me, Papa.
As soon as I can, I will send for her and marry her. I love her.
He loves her. Love. Oh, it's a new style. On the other hand, our old ways were once new, weren't they? But on the other hand, they decided without parents, without their matchmaker. After all, did Adam and Eve have a matchmaker? Yes, they did. These two have the same matchmaker. They're going over my head, unheard of, absurd. For this, they want to be blessed, unthinkable. I'll lock her up in her room. I couldn't. I should! In my daughter's eyes, she loves him. Very well, children. You have my blessing and my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa. You have no idea how happy this makes me.
What else could I do?
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. What am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Perhaps you tell her something like that I'm going to, that I have a rich uncle. Something like that.
Please, Perchik. I can handle my own wife. Golda! Golda! Oh, hello, Golda! I've just been talking with Perchik and Huddle.
Well?
They seem to be very fond of each other.
Well?
I have decided.
decided to give them my permission to become engaged. I have to go inside.
What? Just like this, without even asking me?
Who asks you? I am the father.
Who is he? A pauper? He's nothing, absolutely nothing.
I wouldn't say that. I hear he has a rich uncle. A very rich uncle. He's a good man, Golden. I like him. He's a little crazy, but I like him. What's more important, Otto likes him. Otto loves him. So what can we do, Golden? The new world. Love.
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our daughters getting married and this trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out. Go inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
Go there. I am asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
But do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked the cow. After 25 years, why talk about love right now?
Go there. The first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. Now I'm asking Goldie, do you love me?
I'm your wife.
I know, but do you love me?
Do I love you? For 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. For 25 years my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
Can you love me?
I suppose I do.
And I suppose I love you too.
It doesn't change a thing. But even so, after 25 years, it's nice to know.
You don't have to wait for the train, Papa. You'll be late for your customers.
Just a few more minutes. Is he in bad trouble, that hero of yours? Arrested? And convicted?
Yes, but he did nothing wrong. He does nothing for himself. Everything he does is for humanity.
But if he did nothing wrong, he wouldn't be in trouble.
Oh, Papa, how could you say that? What wrongs did Joseph do, and Abraham and Moses? And they had troubles.
But why won't you tell me where he is now, this Joseph of yours?
It is far, Papa. Terribly far. He is in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? And he asks you to leave your father and mother and join him in that frozen wasteland and marry him there?
No, Papa. He did not ask me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him in his work. It is the greatest work a man can do, Papa.
Otto, baby.
Papa. How can I hope to make you understand why I do what I do? Why I must travel to a distant land? far from the home I love. Once I was happily content to be as I was, where I was, close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love. Who could see that a man would come who would change the shape of my dreams? Helpless now I stand with him, watching older dreams grow dim. Oh, what a melancholy choice this is, wanting home, wanting him, closing my heart to every hope but his, leaving the home I love. There where my heart has settled long ago, I must go, I must go. Who could imagine I'd be wandering so far from the home I love? Yet there with my love, I'm home.
And who, my child, will there be to perform a marriage there in the wilderness?
I promise you, Papa, we'll be married under a canopy.
No doubt their rabbi or two was also arrested. Well, send him my regards, that Moses of yours. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
Papa, God alone knows when we shall see each other again.
Then we shall leave it in his hands. Take care of her. See that she dresses warm.
Mazel tov.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
The little darling has finally arrived.
We've been waiting for so long.
She's beautiful.
I know.
Have you tried it yet?
Look.
Beautiful.
I know, and in less than a minute. Look at how close and even the stitches are.
Beautiful.
I know. My clothes will be perfect. Made by machine. No more handmade clothes.
The rabbi.
Look, rabbi, at my new sewing machine.
Rabbi, is there a blessing for a sewing machine?
There is a blessing for everything. I pray that you keep this sewing machine and bless the work of their hands. Amen.
Amen.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Fiedka.
I came for the shirt.
It's ready.
See, I see. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good day.
Good day.
How does it work?
Look, it's an amazing thing. You work it with your foot and your hand.
Have you spoken to your father?
I will, but I'm afraid.
Hava, let me talk to your father.
No, that would be the worst thing. I'm sure of it.
Let me try.
No. I'll talk to him, I promise.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good day.
What were you and he talking about?
Nothing. We were just talking. Papa, Fiedka and I have known each other for a long time.
Mama, I would be much happier if you'd remain friends from a distance. You must not forget who you are and who that man is.
He has a name, Papa.
Of course. All creatures on Earth have a name.
Fiedka's not a creature, Papa. Fiedka's a man.
Who says he isn't? It's just that he is a different kind of man.
As the good book says, each shall seek his own kind, which translated means a bird may love a fish, but where would they build a home together?
The world is changing, Papa.
No. Some things do not change for us. Some things will never change.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Fiedka and I. We want to be married.
Are you out of your mind? Do you have any idea what this means, marrying outside of the faith?
But Papa!
No! Hava, I said no! Never mention this again. Never speak his name again. Never see him again. Do you understand me?
Yes, Papa, I understand you.
Ah, so you're finally here. Let's go home. It's almost time for supper.
I want to see Mottel's new machine.
You can see it some other time. Let's go home.
Quiet, woman, before I get angry. And when I get angry, even flies don't dare to fly.
I'm very frightened of you. After supper, I'll faint. Let's go home.
Golda, I am the man in the family. I am the head of the house, and I want to see Mottel's new machine now. Okay, let's go home. How long can that miserable horse of mine complain about his leg? Dear God, if I can walk on two legs, why can't he on three? I know, I'm very upset about my horse. He's one of your creatures, and he has the same rights that I have. The right to be sick, the right to be hungry, the right to work like a horse. But dear God, I am sick and tired of pulling this cart. I know. I should push it a while.
Tevye! Tevye!
What is it?
It's Hava. She left home this morning. Fiedka.
What?
I've looked all over for them. I went to the priest. He says they were married.
Mary. Go home, Golden. We have other children at home. Go home, Golden.
But Hava!
Hava is dead to us! We will forget her. Go home.
Little bird, little Kabbalah, I don't understand what's happening today. Everything is all a blur. All I can see is a happy child, the sweet little bird you were, Kabbalah. Thank you.
Papa, I want to talk with you. Papa, stop. At least listen to me. I beg you to accept us.
Accept them? How can I accept them? Can I deny everything I believe? But on the other hand, can I deny my own child? But on the other hand, how can I turn my back on my faith, my people? If I try to bend that far, I'll break. But on the other hand, there is no other hand. No,
Papa!
No!
Papa!
No!
Papa! Papa! Papa!
Tevye, have you seen the constable today?
No. Why?
Well, we heard some rumors around town, and we thought since you know him so well, you might know what is true and what is not.
What rumors?
Someone from Zaladin told me there's an edict issued in Petrograd that all the Jews had to be evicted from their...
Welcome, Your Honor. What's the good news in the world?
I see you have company.
They are my friends.
It's just as well. What I have to say is for their ears also. Tevye, how much time do you need to sell your house and all your household goods?
What? Why should I sell my house? Is it in anybody's way?
I've come here to tell you that you are going to have to leave, Anatevka.
Why does he have to leave?
And how did I come to deserve such an honor?
Not just you. All of you. At first, I thought you might be spared, Tevye, because your daughter Hava.
My daughter is dead.
I understand. At any rate, it affects all of you. You have to leave.
But this corner of the world has always been our home.
We've always lived here.
Why should we leave?
I don't know. There's trouble in the world. Troublemakers.
Like us.
You're not the only ones. The whole district must be empty. I have an order here, and it says that you must sell your homes and be out of here in 3 days.
3 days?
Just you, who have known us all your life, you'd carry out this order?
I have nothing to do with it. Don't you understand?
We understand.
And what if we refuse to go?
You'll be forced out.
We will defend ourselves.
Against our armies? I wouldn't advise it.
I have some advice for you. Get off my land. This is still my home, my land. Get off my land.
You have 3 days.
After a lifetime, a piece of paper and get thee out.
We should defend ourselves. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
Very good. That way the whole world will be blind and toothless.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah all our lives. Would this not be a good time for him to come?
We'll have to wait for him someplace else. Meanwhile, let's start packing.
Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, what have we got here? A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A pot.
A pan.
A broom.
A hat.
Someone should have set a match to this place years ago.
A bench.
A tree.
So what's a stove?
Or a house. The people who passed through Anatevka don't even know they've been here.
A stick of wood.
A piece of gold.
What do we leave? Nothing much. Only Anatevka. Anatevka, Anatevka. Underfed, overworked, Anatevka. Dear else could Sabbath be so sweet? Anatevka. Tevka, on of Tevka, intermit, obstinate, on of Tevka. Where I know everyone I meet. Soon I'll be a stranger in a strange new place, searching for an old familiar face. From Anatevka, I belong in Anatevka, tumble down, work a day. Anatevka, dear little village, little town of mine.
It's just a place. Our forefathers have been forced out of many, many places at a moment's notice.
Maybe that's why we always wear our hats.
We live in America.
With Uncle Abram. But he doesn't know it yet.
I wish you were coming with us.
We'll be staying in Warsaw until we have enough money to join you.
Ah, Matel. My father and mother, may they rest in peace, gave the candlesticks inside to us on our wedding day.
Come, children. Help me pack the rest of the clothes.
Darling, I just had to see you before I left because I have such news for you, Golda. All my life, I've wanted to go to one place, and now I'll walk, I'll crawl, I'll get there. Guess where? You'll never guess. Every year at Passover, what do we say? Next year in Jerusalem? Next year in the Holy Land?
You're going to the Holy Land!
You guessed! And you want to know why? My husband, my Aaron, came to me in my sleep and said, Yenta, go to the Holy Land. Usually I wouldn't listen because too much brains he wasn't blessed with. But in my sleep it's a sign, right? So, somehow or other, I'll go to the Holy Land. And you want to know what I'll do there? I'm a matchmaker, no? I'll arrange marriages, yes? So, I'll go to the Holy Land to help our people increase and multiply. It's my mission. So, goodbye, Golda.
Goodbye, Yenta. Be well. And go in peace.
We'll have to hurry, Goldie. Come, Goldie, we have to leave soon.
Leave? It sounds so easy.
We'll all be together soon. Martel and Zygel, they'll come too. You'll see.
And Hadal and Perchik, when will we ever see them again?
You know what she writes. He sits in prison, and she works, and soon he'll be set free, and together they'll turn the whole world upside down. She couldn't be happier. And the other children will be with us.
Not all.
All. Come, Golda, we have to finish.
I still have to sweep the floor.
Sweep the floor?
I don't want to leave a dirty...
Well, Tevye, I'm off.
Where are you going?
Chicago, in America. My wife, Fruma Sarah, may she rest in peace, has a brother there.
That's nice.
Oh, I hate him, but a relative is a relative. Goodbye, Tevye.
Zygel, are they finished in the house?
Almost, Papa. Papa! Papa will see you.
I want him to. I want to say goodbye to him.
He will not listen.
But at least he will hear.
Maybe it will be better if I told Mom.
Papa! Papa, we came to say goodbye. We are also leaving this place. We are going to Krakow.
We cannot stay among people who do such things to others.
We wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Papa. Goodbye, Mama.
Some are driven away by edicts, others by silence. Come, Hava.
Goodbye, Hava. Vietka.
God be with you.
God be with you.
We will write to you in America if you like.
We will be staying with Uncle Abram.
Yes, Mama.
We will be staying with Uncle Abram. We will be staying with Uncle Abram. The whole world has to know our business.
Stop yelling and finish packing. We have a train to catch.
I don't need your advice, Golda.
Goodbye, Papa.
Goodbye, Mottel.
Goodbye, Mama.
Work hard, Mottel. Come to us soon.
I will, Reb Tevye. I'll work hard.
Come, children. Go, then we can leave that barrel.
No, we can't.
All right, we'll take it.
We're going on a train.
And a boat.
A train and a boat. Stop that. Behave yourselves. We're not in America yet.